He had Schulte as he was trying to get it to him, and he could not. So it's a 9-point lead with a minute 39 to go.
Shane Casey's a rookie in this kind of situation playing.
Bud, I thought he was going to shoot the three. Instead, it was a pass, but Yenge wasn't expecting it, and that turns out to be a costly mistake. Henderson now. Bounce pass up the court. Morrow just holds it. Just hold it. Kicks it back out to Schultes. 14 to shoot. Henderson wide open. Down to Morrow. Drives in. And he will miss, but he will shoot two on the foul.
Good job, Morrow. Taking advantage that they're in the bonus. He can keep he can attack. And Morrow.
Nelson Yenge picks up his fourth of the quarter and of the game. And now Greg Morrow. The man of the match for sure tonight.
26 points on that.
And counting.
And a good rebound corralled by Peter Schultes.
Unreal. They get the rebound. Just everything going the Mustangs' way tonight. Oh, and that's not it.
Quinn Henderson grabbed by the sweater by number 20.
Misses a layup, but he's fouled.
Yenge taking advantage late in the game that the refs aren't going to call things at necessarily
everything.
He was
all over.
All over.
Henderson.
Bear hugging everything. And he knew that, though. He knew Henderson was the last man back for the Mustangs. So by bear hugging him, he gives Bud an easier way to get to the basket.
Bud somehow misses the layup and then misses the free throw. And this is just the kind of effort you wonder. A 6-0 team coming in here clearly does not have their A game tonight.
Well, and they haven't played against the perennial teams of Ottawa or Carleton yet. They're 6-0 teams. Probably their toughest match came against Lakehead.
Frantic pressure. McDonald get it across half, and they eventually do. Must have been close to a violation, and now the fouls begin. With 50.7 seconds left, the Mustangs lead by 9.
Some big free throw attempts coming up for Quinn Henderson.
The Western Mustangs. They're so close now. So close they can taste it. An upset brewing here at Alumni Hall. Henderson will miss the second. The lead is 10. Crazy things have to start happening. Bud drops it off to It's short. Tipped back in. Tipped a couple times. Yenge eventually gets it to go.
Leave it to Yenge to be there to clean that up.
Mustangs
got to be careful here.
Case to Henderson.
Getting Peter Schultes' hands. He's been hauled from the foul line.
Case gets it across the half court line. Henderson, they're going to just pass it around. Are they going to foul eventually?
That's exactly what you want.
It took a lot of time off the clock there before they fouled. And with 24 seconds left, Western leads by 8. Yenge just fouled out, which is big for the Voyageurs. So we've got Schultes now. If he can hit these, that'll pretty much do it. I mean, 8 points is really hard to come back from in this situation anyway, but make it 10, that's pretty much impossible. Ames will come in, the big man who had some good plays down the stretch in that game, or in the first half. Schultes misses the first.
Schultes needs to relax here and just
got the second, though. Timeout will be called here by Laurentian. They want to map up a miracle, potentially. But they're down 9 with 24 to go. Crazy.
It's crazy.
Eric McDonald down the stretch, 2 gigantic threes. That could really be the difference in this game.
The Mustangs TV turning point, as we might soon coin it.
That was it.
You got to expect the Voyageurs to go to Yenge or Rete. Rete, a more capable three-point shooter, and I think three-pointers are going to have to be in order to get back into this game.
At this point, absolutely. You saw down the stretch there, Rete shooting a lot of shots that you might say were forced with maybe too much time left to start forcing those shots, and now they've put themselves in a hole.
You have to take them.
Down 9, pardon me. Yenge just fouled out. And now it's basically Rete And if you're Western, you let them have it too.
You do.
You got to guard the perimeter here.
And the Mustangs, they have the players that can guard the perimeter right now. The key will be communication. There's going to be a lot of screens set. They got to stay with their men. I don't know about Case on Rete right now. They're going to go for a three-pointer. Case gives up a lot of height to Rete. Maybe go back to Henderson on him. We'll see what Brad Campbell has in order for the Mustangs. And some guys are in the foul trouble. I mean, there's only 20 seconds left now, but they have to watch themselves and be careful. So Case will remain on Rete.
They try to get the ball in bounds. Levesque passed it right to McDonald. And that, kids, could be the dagger. An inbounds pass that kind of got stuck to his palm, and just everything down the stretch went perfect for Western, it seemed. And these are the kinds of things that have to happen if you want to pull off an upset. It's McDonald, who was a big boost off the bench in the fourth. Two big-time shots. And now, chance to ice. He misses the second, and Schultes grabs it. They get it out tomorrow, and there's really no point of fouling right now. Clock winds down. They will foul Case.
Seven points for Eric McDonald, all coming in the fourth quarter. Not getting as much playing time as normal. Only 13 minutes tonight, but some big minutes in the fourth quarter.
Made the most of them, absolutely. Case makes his first, looking ahead to tomorrow. Could it be back-to-back wins? Would we ever have thought we would say that? Algoma playing tomorrow night. And another offensive rebound, it looks like. A fight for it. Jump ball. It's still Western's. 10 seconds left. Just let it run out, boys. Laurentian, stop fouling, please. This is one of the things they don't like. You're clearly not going to win. You're down by 11 with 10 seconds left. Just let it play out. Algoma comes to the gym tomorrow night.
And
here we go. The Western Mustangs. Few expected them to do this with a 6-0 team coming into town, but they're on the board. Their first win of the season. 88-77. The Western Mustangs are victorious. And it's Greg Morrow leading the way with 27 huge points. What a game. Henderson 18. Schultes 18. And McDonald down the stretch only had 7, but what a big 7 they were, David.
A huge game. Case did a great job anchoring the team, coming up big. Kalu had some big plays here. Spritas had some big steals. A full throttle team effort by the Western Mustangs against the Voyageur team that did not have an answer.
Rarely you would say a team that shot 54% from the field came without their A game, but it just didn't seem like down the stretch they had it going on. They end up shooting 54% from the floor, not enough. 88-77 is the final. The three-point shooting from Western, the difference. They hit 10. Laurentian only hit 2. So for David Mann and the entire Mustangs TV crew, my name is Christian O'Mell. Tune in tomorrow for volleyball on Mustangs TV. And then in the evening time, the volleyball is in the afternoon. Evening time, you've got Algoma coming to town, their first ever visit to Alumni Hall. When they take on the women at 6, the men at 8. My name is Christian Mel. Thank you for watching. The Mustangs sweep the doubleheader against Laurentian. Have yourself a good night.
On behalf of the Western Mustangs basketball team, thank you for turning out this evening. Enjoy a safe drive home. Good night.
Will you count me in? I've been awake for a while now. You got me feeling like a child now. Cause every time I see your bubbly face, I get the tingles in a silly place. It starts in my toes and I crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now. Just take your time wherever you go. The rain is falling. being safe and warm. You give me feelings that I adore. They start in my toes, make me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time. Wherever you go, what am I gonna say? Make me feel this way. I just and it starts in my toes, makes me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time. Wherever you go. Starts in my soul, and I lose all control when you kiss my nose.